got a good amount of stuff, too. But fist bumps all around. We're about to hop right into it. And not before we switch up some music. Planet Pop Star. Ah, only middle. What are they putting up into higher? Dreamland all the way up? Okay, okay. I buy it, I guess. But we're going to Kirby 64. Possibly, not sure who had first pick, but it could be that Wawa and Gons were thinking that the Gusts could stop Bayonetta's combos, possibly. Or it could at least help in some way. And we're seeing right now Trebbi just going all across all platforms, trying to cover as most areas he can. Gets a witch time already, but Gons interrupts it. Very nice. And he gets an immediate response, and Trebbi's already at 95%, and Gons hasn't been touched, and now he has. 70%, or 7%. But yeah, Wario's aerials should be able to pose at least a fair amount of formidable force against Bayonetta, at least, I'd say. So long as he's predictive of Trebbi's movements and attacks. Which, since the nerf, it's a little trickier because most of the time she had tried and true setups to get kills, but now you actually have to work for him. But a clean, not clean, but an up air kill will send Wawa Peach out for first stock taken down. And let's see. Delibird's trying to get back, and Wawa Peach didn't get two frame, so he'll come back. But Wawa's right there to respond, and he gets it with the same move. Takes both stocks down just like that. And here we see Wario trying to find his way in. He's playing a little bit like the style of a stock tank right now. You know, he's feinting back, just trying to get his opportunities moving in when he absolutely, or either when he absolutely or when he thinks he can get at least damage racked up. John's having a little trouble while we're forcing Trebbi off stage here. A little bit of pressure, but he slides through. Didn't connect with anything, though. Good reverse back with that spear jump. Or lance jump, whatever you want to call it. And can... Oh, Trebbi was so close to getting a top kill off the top. And he didn't have a jump by the look of it. And he couldn't snap to the ledge. So it's another stock taken for Trebbi. Not looking too good for the red team right now. And again, Gon's holding on. He still has 119. And he still has his first stock taken by mistake. Almost gets taken out by his teammate. Red team has control of the stage. And yeah, there wasn't really that much of an option because Wawa was going to go down. Gons was safe, so it was just a matter of circumstances who wanted to get back first. And Wawa said, I want to get back. So he used his charge climb hazard. And he gets sent down again. And just like that, it's pretty much evened up. These are the things that happens in doubles. It can be reversed any second. And a good amount of damage off that witch time. And he could get a kill off the top here, and he does! And that forces the share stock option. Yep, and there it is. We've seen a complete reversal in this game. It was heavily in Blue's favor, then shifted heavily in the red team's favor. This is a great match to start off this tourney here today. Can he get one again? Oh, it hit off Corrin. Corrin's up B, finished them off, but Wawa's up air took him out as well. One stock all around. Bayonetta's the only one with high damage, so Trebbi's going to be playing a little more safer. Good counter. And they'll get back to stage as well. Corrin should be doing the brunt of the work here because as soon as you lose that 2-1 advantage, it becomes obviously all that more difficult. You want to keep the pressure on him as well. Misread on that slide kick there, but he's hopping right back into it because it was a shielded, or because it was shielded. He has charge on limit on deck here though. Finding his way, he's just fishing for a kill right now, trying to get it off Trebbi. But right now, they're just racking up damage. They're very aware of what Wawa Peach can do here. Almost gets the read, but a back air almost takes him out. He'll have to burn that charge. Yep. And gets on stage. He was looking for a safer option, probably. Tries to get the two-frame dragon. What I'm not sure about the name on that, so I'll just say B. And a clean, I think that was up air. That'll take first round. A complete reversal. That was heavily in Blue Team's favor, and then it just shifted right back with all those circumstances. And great job by the Red Team, just hanging in, not giving up. Uh-oh. Alright, round two. Yeah, it was last stock, so they probably weren't considering any shifts or changes in the characters. But we see a shift here in Battlefield. I only know this because Trebbi got a really good kill, I think, one or two tourneys ago. That Bayo kind of likes this stage a little bit. It's got a good amount of platforms, so, like, the setups to kill can be... are just multiplied by that much. But I'm guessing they chose it maybe because platforms can interrupt, Korin's neutral game a little bit. Possibility. And Wawa already has charge on deck. And right now, the focus pretty... yeah. It's good on them to focus on Wario this time around, because he was playing stock tank last time, but he already has 107. Blue team really at high percentages. And first stock taken down by Trebbi taking out Wawa Peach's first one. Oh, that was very close. Delibird was able to squeeze that in with that up B and was able to recover. Blue team has control of the main stage here. Red team trying to get back on, but these aerials are keeping them out, especially Wawa. Gonzilla almost takes out with an up smash. Red team's trying to get a little bit of a foothold, but yeah, didn't have a jump on deck, and Trebbi got sent out, but so did Gonzilla as well. And a broken shield! Get a full charge, and okay, that was the best punish, but yeah, he was looking for the kill, but didn't get it. But yeah, that's a bad set of circumstances there for that broken shield. And too much DI probably won't get him that kill off the top that Trebby's fishing for right now. Or that Bayonettos are usually fishing for, actually. Bayo's having a little bit of trouble right in between those two blue players. And blue starting to get a little bit more of a foothold on this match. Delibird missed that up smash. Pressure. That charge, yeah, that's really ridiculous. I still don't like Korin for that. Her forward smash has that razor blade or chainsaw sword that protects it from basically any forward approaching attacks. And it's an edge guard too, so that's just crazy. Not a lot of Korin players, but like, you know, if you know how to utilize her, she can be pretty formidable at times. Stock taken down, and let's see. Gonzilla has still two stock here. And at 90%, he'll still hang on because he's a heavy character. So they'll have to put in a fair amount more work. Right now, Wawa trying to find purchase with any of these attacks. And right now, he's getting bombarded by both red team. Gonzilla tried to get in. Broke it up a little bit. And he's back on the foothold. But Trebbi trying to get something done. Wawa has full charge. And again... counter takes out Gonzilla, but or on his last stock there, but yeah, that's a problem with Bayo. Basically the same set of circumstances with like a Luigi. If you burn a jump or two, I mean, she does have a lot more versatility in terms of getting back on stage than Luigi does, but like as soon as you burn that jump or two, she has a little bit of trouble getting back. And I guess he was just too far out, and a charge cross slash will be able to chalk one up for the blue team here. 1-1. Okay. So, again, I don't think they'll swap characters. I think it's just a shift in play style that they need there. So, we'll see. Maybe Delibird might swap. Oh, no. They're choosing stage. So we'll see what they pick here. Oh. Where is Delibird going? Where is Delibird going? Delibird! Delibird, get back! Get back there, Delibird! What the heck is going on? Oh, he was going to get his water. Okay. Gotta keep hydrated, but again, that's one of the problems that we have. We're isolated back here, the commentators. We don't know what's going on in terms of the stream match. just scuttled off. Yeah, it just looks so funny. Probably catching a Pokemon. I like that 80X. Or 80X, that's nice. And they were debating stage. Yeah, okay, so they're just debating stage here. And Battlefield again. All right. I kind of like the option. I think Trebbi's looking for those setups and kills that Bayo is still known for. Right now, red team holding pretty... Okay, as soon as I say... I was going to say red team's holding that right side of the stage pretty well there, but, you know, they shifted right over sometimes. And Wawa going in with those up airs. Never approach a cloud from up above, because he can just throw in that short hop or full hop up air, and it just stuffs out practically anything that doesn't have, like, a hurtbox going downward. You have to get really lucky with that, too. Gonzilla gets the chomp on Trebbi there. Bayo sent high. Gonzilla tried to respond with an up smash through the platform, not getting it, but an up air will send Trebbi up again, and Delibird's having a little bit of time trying to find purchase on Gonzilla. Gets it finally, but Wawa responds with a dash attack. Tried to look for the counter there, but didn't get it. He was probably looking for a limit attack there. And that's so dangerous. Whenever Cloud dashes like that, he can throw out that side B at any moment. That probably should have... I don't know, yeah. Trebbi's showing a little... At least in friendlies, he was playing friendlies with me, and he was talking about those smash attacks. As soon as you hit it with a hurt box, it basically cancels out the hurt box on itself, so you can throw out a move and just walk up and hit Bayonetta while she's still doing her little animation. And a down smash from Wawa will take out a Delibird's first stock. And it'll be first stock taken. Everybody else on very high percentages. Back throw, yeah, that'll take out Trebbi. But a clean forward smash will take out Wawa Peach's first stock. And again, they got to watch out for Gonzilla, especially since he has Waft already on board here. And I just realized, oh, no, no. Okay, that's right. And back air will take out Gonzilla's, so there it is. All right. Delibird's got to play a little bit more carefully. He's going in on Wario that has Waft ready with a down air, which has a good amount of lag on it afterward. So he's got to play just a tiny bit more apprehensive, I'd say. Or at least know what he's getting into. Wawa almost has charge or limit on deck. Next hit will probably do it. Oh, no. Second next hit. Third. Come on. Stop making me a liar here. Oh, my gosh. There it is. Up air sends Trebbi, but he gets back down in center stage. Blue team has a tiny bit more control of the stage here. I think Delibird should throw out a little bit more neutral game. Because he's going in with a lot of attacks that just leave him vulnerable. And, like, he's trying to find purchase on Gonzilla and Wawa, like, very close by. And you're asking for trouble when you do that. An accidental up air will take out his teammate by mistakes there. And let's see. Grab from Wawa sends Delibird off stage. Should get back unless, yeah, he wasn't interrupted. Back throw takes out Delibird, and he's red team on last stock. Blue team put a pretty good job shifting in gameplay from, like, the first match. Yeah. And again, you got to be careful with those team attacks. One accidental hit can shift the game. Which time? Wawa, yeah, he was... very close by, so I didn't expect them to get anything off that. But it was a good effort, though. That charge, but Trebbi again interrupts him. Again, these team attacks are not working out for the red team right now. And again, Trebbi tried to neutral air Delibird there, but Cloud's got a low shield. He's got to play very carefully. So he's gonna back off, try to let Gonzilla do most of the work, but right now Trebbi is in his face, gets an up air. See if he can cap anything off it. Gonzilla was there to back him up though. Wawa throws an up air of his own. Good tech, but an up smash, I believe, will take him out. And yeah, that run forward charge. And that's a 2-1 for Gonzilla and Wawa. They will advance to round two of doubles. Let me pull up bracket on my phone here, see what's... Okay, that's our main problem back here. We don't have, like, a screen for a bracket or anything. So I gotta pull it up on phone here. Ooh. Noises. WBB 40. Oh, it actually popped up. Okay, so Wawa Peach and Gonzilla will be back on stream. Let me see who they're facing. I just heard it through the wall. Alright, so, yeah, Blue and Chaos. Okay. I didn't even see Blue show up. Jacob Kang, this is a weekly. Wii Bear B-airs is the weekly, and we have a monthly called Brotherly Love. You can search those on our Facebook page or on smash.gg as well. They're weekly, so this is what? This is the 40th one. And Wii Bear B-airs, I think, is on 16, will be the next one. We'll have announcements, Danimals, it's weekly. We usually have ads that show up here that'll show, like, when the next Brotherly Love is. We'll see if we can throw that up, sometime soon. I'll try to mention into it, if I'm ever pulled off commentary, and, I'll tell Moose to throw it up for you guys. Because I am not sure myself. But yeah, this is a weekly. And if you're able to get down here tomorrow, we have the Philadelphia Summer Smash Arcadian. And the only prerequisite for that is that you cannot be placed in any PR top 10. Or basically any rankings, any official Smash rankings. You can't be in the top 10 of any of them. So basically, like, new players or players that normally can't win tourneys or things like that can get a chance to show off their skills and possibly take a tourney. I know myself and Trebbi will be there. I know a good amount of people here will be there, and I know there's a ton of new faces. Last chance to sign up for that is tonight, by the way. So, yeah, and if you're going to watch Evo as well, I can see what we're doing here. Throw us up in a multi-stream. The website that I use is multistre.am, multistre.am, and then you can just input the names of the stream channels and then press a button and they'll throw them up for you. It'll reduce the quality so that it can run both, like, at the same time, like in live time, in live actually. And there's a chat thing off the side there where you can just pull up a little drop-down menu, choose which chat you want to enter, and then you're right there. So, yeah. And multitwitch.tv also works as well. And yeah, make sure if you're going to watch Evo, make sure you give, if you know any locals from the Philly area or New Jersey area even that are there, make sure to give them the support. Because, you know, in the grand spectacle that is Evo, you know, if you know you got people backing you up, it helps out big time. Like, the nerves on that grand stage is just... I couldn't even imagine it. Like, I am in no way prepared for Evo, but, like, getting nerves on stage like that would be insane. So, just let people know that you, they got people in their corner cheering for them. Alright, so we're about to hop into here. Sheik and Charizard. I don't remember Chaos playing all that much, I don't think. Either that or I'm just forgetful. Let's see. And Charizard, that's expected from Blue. Swapping colors here. But yeah, Charizard, Blue runs amok with Charizard. And cheek. Like, she's still, you know. I don't think she's top 10, but she's very close, I'd say. Maybe. But. Yeah, let's see how they fare up against this team that we saw before. Already